In August, there were some volatility for the ruble in auctions. Do you see more volatility in the upcoming months, and do you see the premium going up?
Well, yes, we had a successful auction yesterday. It was quite a good one. Honestly, I think everybody expects some volatility in the fourth quarter of this year, given the overall geopolitical situation, the upcoming U.S. elections, and the situation with the COVID-19. So these factors are certainly going to play some role in the overall volatility on the market. But we are very comfortable that what we see is gives us some confidence that we will be able to accomplish all our borrowing plans. You know that about 70% of our investors base are local banks and funds. And we don't expect any deterioration to their financial standing and their ability and willingness to take on more sovereign risk. So, we understand that some foreign investors, and about 30% of our portfolio is in the hands of foreign investors. Well, they might get a bit frightened by what's happening in the world, but we still expect significant demand from local banks, local funds, and that will certainly allow us to fulfill our borrowing plans.
You mentioned non-residents. Do you think the share of non-residents can go down before the U.S. elections, or do you think them, flocking back in after the election?
The share of non-residents is around 29% at this point. It used to be 35, but since we're switching between instruments from the plain vanilla bonds mainly to floaters, and we see that non-residents are not so keen to take these instruments because they're mainly protection instruments, and what they seek in Russia is the return on their investments. Meanwhile, local banks and funds, they seek some protection from potential interest rate changes in the future. So we certainly expect the share of non-residents go down as we increase the amount of floaters that we offer to the market.